Hello, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm doing a video today on solving equations by factoring, and these are the three problems that we're going to solve in this video, the three equations that we're going to solve. To solve an equation to the second power, which are called quadratic equations, we use the following property, the zero product property. And what that says, if A times B equals zero, then A equals 0 or B equals 0 or both. Because you can't multiply two things and get 0 unless one of them is 0 or maybe both of them could be 0. So, in other words, our goal is to factor so that we can use this property, because if we factor things into multiplication problem, then we can use it. So finally, a reason to factor. All right, example 1. So we did a review of factoring recently so that when you got to this point, you could remember all the different ways that you can factor. In this problem, this is a quadratic equation or a second power equation. You can see that we have a power of 2. If you had this problem, x minus 6 equals 0, you would expect to get one answer because x is to the first power. You would add 6 to both sides, and you would say x equals 6, one answer. When you have something to the second power, you expect to get two solutions, typically. We'll see some examples where you don't, but most of the time you get two. So take out the common factor. That's all you can do here. You've got two terms. You've got a common factor of x. When I say take that out, what am I really saying? I'm really saying divide both of those things by x, right? You could write x a little nicer. X squared over x is x, and 6x over x is 6. Don't forget about the minus sign there. So now we actually have written this in this form, AB. This is like x is like our A, and x minus 6 is like our B. So we're saying A times B equals 0. So to solve this, we set both parts, x equals 0, and x minus 6 equals 0. We set both parts equal to 0. So we factor, then we set all of our factors equal to 0. Well, this is already solved. And if I was to add 6 to both sides like I did up here, we would see x equals 6. So there's my two solutions. So x equals 0 and 6. Two different solutions. Is it true? Do they both actually work? Well, let's plug in 0. 0 squared minus 6 times 0, that's definitely 0. What about 6? 6 squared minus 6 times 6, does that equal 0? Well, that's 36 minus 36, which, yes, it does. So both of those work, 0 and 6. Okay, second one we have is p squared. Well, I don't know why we have an x in there, because that doesn't make sense. And if you saw that in the original problem, I still didn't catch it until just now. We should have the same variable. Sorry about that. Okay, you know, making mistakes is part of doing math. And hopefully you find your mistakes before you go too far and before you make a fool of yourself like maybe I just have. Okay, so we're going to factor this. This is a trinomial, so I want to factor it using the box method because that's the method I use. If by now you don't need the box, you can see the answer, that would be fantastic. The box method is there if you need it. Certainly don't spend time on the box method if you don't need it. P squared has to be P times P. And then I have 20, and I'm trying to get to 8. Let's look at the factors of 20. I have 1 times 20, 2 times 10, 4 times 5. Which one of those could possibly get me to 8? Well, it's 2 and 10, so I'm going to use 2 and 10. Remember to use a pencil if you're new to factoring so you can try things out. Now, I want to multiply across. I get 2p and 10p, and then I ask myself which one of those needs to be negative. Well, I want more negative, so I want the 10 to be negative. And if I check that, I get 2p and negative 10p, which adds up to negative 8p. So I have factored this now. My factorization, remember, is on the diagonal. Doesn't matter which one you put first. P plus 2 and p minus 10 equals 0. And now you have to do the next step. After you factor, you set each of your factors equal to 0 because we're trying to solve this thing, not just factor it. So I'm going to say P plus 2 is 0 and P minus 10 is 0, which means P is negative 2 or P is positive 10 because we add 10 to both sides, subtract 2 from both sides. So we're trying to get you into where you can kind of be solving those just by looking at them sometimes. Here's what I think my two solutions are. I could easily check this. What about negative 2? Negative 2 squared minus 8 times negative 2 minus 20. Does that equal 0? Whoops, I'm off the page here. Sorry. Does it equal 0? Well, negative 2 squared is 4 plus 16 minus 20. That is 20 minus 20, which equals 0. Yes. What about 10? Well, that would be 10 squared minus 8 times 10 minus 20. And that would be 100 minus 80 minus 20. And that, sure enough, equals 0. So both of those are solutions. Expect two solutions if you have something to the second power. That's a nice rule to remember. And now the last one, though, we're going to break that rule. This is a trinomial, so you can factor by the box method, and hopefully maybe on this one you don't need the box, but I'll write it down in case you do. We have y squared. We got our variables matching. That's good. We have positive 4, and down below we have positive 4y. So we have y times y, and how are we going to multiply two numbers to get 4 and add two multiply and add two numbers to get 4? Well, that's going to be 2 and 2. 2y and 2y add up to 4y. So I have the same thing on both diagonals. So if I write that y plus 2 and y plus 2, well, obviously, if I set both of those equal to 0, I get the same answer. So in that case, we just say, well, y equals negative 2. So we had two solutions, but they were the same one. So we call that a double root. That's an exception where we just get one solution. Typically, when you have something to the second power, you're going to see two solutions. All right, have a fantastic day.